Thursday, July the 16th. I think my squelch is down a little too much. Let's see, here we go. Borland traffic, Cherokee 8302 Whiskey. It's going to be back taxiing 17 to the run-up area, Borland.
Oh, you have a run-up area?
You know, kind of.
Is there space for two, or should I wait here for you?
No, come on. It's a little taxiway. I say run-up area, so if somebody's passing by that's never been here, they think it's cool.
Oh, yeah.
There is a run-up area down on the other end, though, because there's no taxiway. Borland traffic, Cherokee 830 to Whiskey's clear 17.
And Borland traffic, 19 Romeo, clear 17. Do you want to stay on?
Just stay on this one if you want to.
Roger.
Portland traffic, Cherokee 830 to Whiskey's departing 17. We're going to be departing the pattern to the northwest, Portland.
Left turn out, right?
Roger. I hope my drink stays in the cup holder.
It's going to be in your lap. Pulling traffic, 19 Romeo, gonna line up and wait for the departing traffic.
Portland traffic, Cherokee 302 Whiskey's turning left crosswind, runway 17, departure to the northwest, Portland.
Portland traffic, 3119 Romeo, on the roll, 17, departure, left turnout, Portland.
At about 500 foot a minute.
Roger. We're going to 3,000, right?
Roger that.
Sure.
Bourland traffic, 190 Romeo, turning left crosswind, 17. Bourland. And 190 Romeo, continuing the turn left downwind, 17. Bourland.
I've got 377 on wingtip. There's a little radio tower down there to my right. I'm at 2,000 feet.
I got a visual.
About 123 is my ground speed right now.
Roger. Are you squawking?
1200, yep.
Alright, I'm gonna go ahead and stand by since we're gonna get so close, it'll start setting their stuff off.
Sounds good. I'm a little off the line, I need to come back a little left.
Roger, do what you need to do. I'm just catching up to you.
Okay, 3,000, I'm a little out.
21, climbing.
You know, it's funny, you have your new 650 to play with, and I have a new vertical speed indicator to play with. So I'm excited about that, just as probably as much as you are yours.
Nice. I'm climbing at 1,200 feet a minute.
Yeah, whatever. I can do that too if I have about 10 gallons of gas in the plane and I'm the only one in it.
Yeah, and a 70 degree nose up.
Roger that.
I'm level 13 and I'm coming for you. Hey, why don't you go ahead and switch over to 12345?
Frequency 12345?
Yeah, 12345.
Okay.
You up?
Yes, sir.
Hey, hey. It's a unicom for a lot around here, so we'll kick on this one.
Roger that. That's Navy off to the right, and Lake Worth that it runs up into.
Very nice. That's a big airport.
Yeah, it is. Real big. And I live, when you get to where I'm at, and look straight up, there's some hangars there on the north end, the north side of the airport. I say it's north side, I guess it's more like the east side. I live just a little bit northeast of the hangars there.
Very cool.
Yeah. Okay, I'm on the line. I actually climbed up to 3,500 feet because this thing does not want to not climb. So that's where I'm at.
That's still under the veil?
Yeah. We're good. 6,000 feet is where we're at right now.
All right, I'll join you at 3,500.
I'm showing 147 ground speed.
I'm still climbing, 126.
All right, you want a little Fort Worth history?
Shoot.
See the island there in the middle of Lake Worth?
Is it?
Called Wolf Island. And the so the story goes, there is a wolf man that lives in the lake, and that island is where he resides and lives until somebody comes out to explore, and then he goes back in the water.
Oh, cool.
Yeah.
Yeah, freak.
Hey, that's just what they said. There are gators in the lake, though, for sure.
Yeah, no thanks. You got traffic crossing you. Left side.
Does it show how high?
400 feet below us. He just crossed our line now. Oh, he's just directly in front of you.
No, I never saw him. That ADS-B must be a pretty cool thing. Over the Eagle Mountain Party Cove, and it's a legitimate, probably not as Party Cove as Lake Travis, but it's our version.
Hi, what's your ground speed?
145.
I'm showing 141. Jeez, are you miles or not?
No, I'm miles. Everything I have is miles.
Let me change mine. Hold on.
You're probably cutting about 165.
Not bad.
Okay, see the row, look off to the right, just east of the lake there. And you see the row of white buildings there? That's another airport. That's Hicks Airfield. That's where I got my license.
Very nice.
Straight ahead is Kenneth Copeland's airport.
Nice. Oh yeah, we'll overfly that pretty much.
Oh yeah.
southwest of Pembroke Lake. Anyone from Delta Qualify up in the south practice area, please advise 147.
Is it hard for you to fly this slow?
I'm at full right now, just catching up to you.
Oh, okay. I'm right on my line, but I think I think we used, when I got in the airplane, right now I'm noticing that my waypoint was actually Copeland Airport, so just use a couple of different lines, I guess.
Oh, okay, that's cool. I'll just follow you.
Yeah, my bad. I didn't think about having you change it or telling you. I'm a loner, man. I'm used to flying alone. I'm sorry.
Stand for your far pilot.
That's right. That's why I need my cut.
That'd be cool.
Yeah, it would be kind of goofy, wouldn't it? All right, now you're going to have to go in first in the International, and don't leave me in the dark, because I'm still...
November 1, Juliet Whiskey, maintain VFR at or above 4,000. There's traffic at your 1 o'clock. Christian, 2 o'clock, 2 miles, northbound at 3,500 to Cessna.
161 Juliet Whiskey, at or above 4,000.
November 1, 9 Romeo, maintain VFR at or above 4,000.
At or above 4,000, 1 9 Romeo, we do, field and safe.
Roger.
Call for approach, Commander 1-1, 14 Juliet, level 9 or 500.
November 9, Charlie Delta, turn left heading 360, clear direct Chanute.
Turn left heading 360, clear direct Chanute.
9 Charlie Delta, correction, turn left heading 040, clear direct Neosho.
Left 040, clear direct to Neosho.
November 19 Romeo, turn 20 degrees left, vector for sequence. You'll be following a Cirrus at your 11 o'clock and 3 miles northeastbound at 5,500 descending.
Alright, 20 left, following the Cirrus, we'll look for him. 19 Romeo.
Other calling approach and answer taken.
Bonanza 14 Juliet, level 9,500.
Bonanza 1114 Juliet, Tulsa approach, Tulsa altimeter 2985.
Riverside, no, Riverside, okay, sorry. 14
Juliet.
November 1 Juliet Whiskey, contact approach on 119.1.
119.1, 161 Juliet.
Are we good at or below 5,500?
About 5,000. Central aircraft information, India is current at Riverside Jones, Tulsa altimeter is 2985. November 19 Romeo, the Cirrus is at your 11 o'clock and 2 miles northbound at 5,100 descending.
19 Romeo, we're still looking.
And 19 Romeo, just to verify, you are a flight of two Cessnas?
Negative, my wingman broke off, he's on his own squad.
November 19 Romeo, roger, thank you.
Post approach, this is Cessna, November 19, 450. 904505, receiving on 124.0.
November 904505, Tulsa approach, roger. Expect runway 19 right, verify information India.
I have information India, 19 right, 904505.
November 19 Romeo, flight heading 360, the traffic's now 2 miles north of your position, northbound at 4,600.
360, 19 Romeo.
19 Romeo, contact approach on 119.1.
There's the airport.
119.1.
Number 21, Papa, proceed northbound.
Proceed northbound, 542 up, Papa.
Where's it at?
At 1 o'clock. It's an empty field. That's all you can see right now. It's just the empty field. You barely see the runway.
Oh, okay. I think I got it now. I see the touchdown markers. I think.
November 21, Papa, what's your requested altitude?
5,500, 542 on Papa.
2 1 Papa, roger, VFR altitude at your discretion and proceed on course.
Proceed on course, VFR climbing.
Cherokee 8302 Whiskey Tulsa approach.
Cherokee 8302 Whiskey Tulsa approach.
Yes ma'am, I just wanted to confirm we are setting up for the right side, correct?
November 02 Whiskey negative, runway 18 right is closed. You can plan on runway 18 left, turn right heading 020 and maintain VFR at or above 3500.
Right heading 020, 3500, 02 Whiskey.
Archer, 6 Papa Delta, 240 on the heading, through 1200 for 25.
November 6 Papa Delta, Tulsa Departure, radar contact, climb and maintain VFR at 3000, as maintain VFR at or below 3000, traffic 11 o'clock, 2 miles, northbound at 3500, a Seneca.
Okay, and header 3000, maintain 3000, 240 on the heading.
November 9, Christian 6 Papa Delta, you might see additional traffic at 12 o'clock and 2 miles northbound at 4,000 to Cessna.
We're looking.
02 Whiskey, many altitude, maintain VFR at or above 4,000.
At or above 4,000 for 8302 Whiskey.
Delta, roger, additional traffic, you're 12 o'clock, 1 mile northbound at 3,500, set Seneca.
That's Tally Ho, I have that one.
Six Papa Delta, roger, maintain visual separation, set traffic, climb on course, and what's your requested altitude?
6,500.
Six Papa Delta, roger, 6,500 is approved.
And departure, Lear 306 Alpha Victor is with you in the climb out of 4,000, run no heading.
Former 306 Alpha Victor, Tulsa departure, radar contact, continue runway heading. November 6 Alpha Victor, turn right heading 210.
210 6AV.
Brian just trying to get a hold of Brian. He's texting me, telling him to get on the frequency. I'm like, we only got one NAVCOM.
November 21 Papa's traffic at your 1 o'clock and 3 miles northbound, assess that 4,100, they'll be descending for Tulsa.
Trying to keep it out, traffic best I can.
Oh yeah.
November 02 Whiskey, descend and maintain VFR at 4,000.
Descend and maintain VFR 4,000 for 8302 Whiskey.
November 6 Alpha Victor, traffic 1 o'clock, 5 miles northbound, Cherokee at 5,000, turn right, heading 310, clear direct fax.
Hear alarm going off.
Direct tracks will look for the traffic 6AV. We're out of 7,000 now.
Not good.
November 21 Papa, turn 10 degrees left vector to keep you out of Tulsa's arrival corridor.
10 degrees left, 542 on Papa.
Also approach control, Hawker 850 Kilo Echo is level leveling now, 10,000.
Hawker 850 Kilo Echo, Tulsa approach, Tulsa 2153 Zulu, weather wind 17016, visibility 10, few clouds at 5,000, temperature 35, dew point 23, altimeter is 29 or 85. Plan on the visual approach, runway 18 left.
That's a cool shot if you can get a picture downtown.
Visual to 18 left.
I'll see if I can do, standby.
29 85 on the altimeter, 0 Kilo Echo.
November 0 Kilo Echo, proceed direct to Owasso, descend and maintain 4,000.
Okay, party 10,000 for 4,000 direct or Owasso.
I don't know if I can get it or not. Let me see my phone. Rapido, rapido. Muy rapido, ahora.
November 6 Alpha Victor, contact Kansas City Center 127.8, good day.
27.8, 6AV, good day.
Port. Yup, nice.
November 02 Whiskey, contact approach on 119.1.
119.1, 02 Whiskey, see ya.
Sam.
Andrew, contact Tulsa Tower 121.2. Have a good day.
1-1-2-0, 6 seconds.
Tulsa Approach, Cherokee 8302 Whiskey, checking in at 4000.
Cherokee 8302 Whiskey, Tulsa Approach. Roger, altimeter's 2985, you are number 5 to the airport.
Number 5, 8302 Whiskey, thank you, sir.
November 19 Romeo, turn right heading 090.
090, 19 Romeo.
If you still have the Seneca in sight, you can follow him to the airport.
19 Romeo, affirm.
Thank you. And November 19 Romeo, delete your altitude restriction.
19 Romeo.
All right, 4,000 feet. 4,000. I'm going to need you. There's a pen and paper in there if you want to write down if they give us taxiways to take.
Nice. Awesome. And
pens deep down in there, probably somewhere around
I got you.
Okay. We're recording.
November 02 Whiskey, descend to maintain 3,000 and turn right heading 030.
Descend to maintain 3,000, right heading 030. 02 Whiskey.
Tulsa Approach, Hawker 850 Kilo Echo, passing 6,500 for 4,000.
Hawker 850 Kilo Echo, Tulsa Approach, Roger, expect runway 18 left.
Okay, we expect 18 left, 0 Kilo Echo.
November 19 Romeo, contact TEL 118.7, good day.
118.7, 19 Romeo, good day.
Tulsa International Airport.
Yep.
Automated weather observation.
I guess they're AWOS. Ripon Fisk Arrival Echo.
I guess their AWOS is down or something like that.
I guess ADIS is, yeah.
And I'm sorry, call and approach again, please.
Fisk Arrival Echo has Tulsa insight.
No, I'm sorry, we had one going to the wrong runway and we're trying to work out calling the tower. Was that 06-0-0-Kilo-Echo with the field in sight?
That's affirmative.
Okay, thank you, sir. November 0-Kilo-Echo, you will clear digital approach runway 18 left. You're following a Cessna on a 4-mile final.
Okay, clear for that visual 18 left, Cessna 4-mile final, 0-Kilo-Echo.
Turn left, heading 360.
Left, heading 360, 02 Whiskey.
Number 02 Whiskey, for planning purposes, you're going to follow a Hawker inbound about 10 miles north of the airport. They're quite a bit faster than you, but it shouldn't be too long for your base.
Roger that.
Stops we're making tomorrow, you think?
Huh?
How many stops we're making tomorrow, you think?
We're making, we're going to stop the fuel just right over here. And then,
Over 02 Whiskey, you can start looking for traffic 1 to 2 o'clock, 10 miles. Opposite directions, a Hawker at 2,800, joining about an 8-mile final for runway 18 left.
I'll be looking for him, 02 Whiskey.
Hawker 0-Kilo Echo, your traffic's now on a 2-mile final. Speed and spacing is compatible. Contact tower 118.7, so long.
18-7, 0-Kilo Echo. Good day, sir. Thanks for the help.
Good day.
What did he say, a 10-mile final?
No, he said 8 miles out. I'm still hunting for him. I don't got him. He said opposite direction.
he's on a final. But I think we're full. There he is.
8302 Whiskey, I got the Hawker in sight.
November 8302 Whiskey, roger. Follow the Hawker, caution wake turbulence for left, correction, right base, runway 18 left.
Following the Hawker for right base, 18 left, 8302 Whiskey. Thank you, sir.
Plenty of space.
He's pretty fast too though. I think he's cruising pretty quick.
November 02 Whiskey, delete your altitude restriction contact tower 118.7. So long.
Going to the tower at 118.7. See ya.
Tulsa Tower, Cherokee 8302 Whiskey, right base, I apologize, right base 18 left, going to come in behind the Hawker.
719 Romeo, contact ground point nine.
Point nine, Romeo.
November 8302 Whiskey, Tulsa Tower, following the Hawker, wind 20015, gust up to 22, and 18 left, clear to land.
Clear to land, 18 left, 02 Whiskey.
We're gonna kill Ryan when we get on the ground.
Why? Because he took off?
Oh no! We're gonna get the right side. We're for sure gonna get the right side. It's just gonna be a quick turn.
Yeah, nice.
Yeah. And I'll let him hear this on the audio too. You hear that, Ryan?
Yeah.
You hear that, Ryan? Where's that Hawker? There he is.
Yep.
Man, he's way up there.
Yeah, he's quick, man.
Actually, I don't.
He's already, I don't even see him. I think he's already down.
Yeah, you're good, man.
There he is. I think he's just touched down, maybe.
Yep. Now, you feel how I pulled up on the airplane to reduce my speed to get me within my flap range?
Oh, yeah.
But this is a long final, so we're going to take it in nice and easy.
Do you have to catch ground frequency by chance?
Point niner. 118, so it's going to be 118 point.
Niner. Nice.
Niner.
Yeah, hopefully we don't get lost.
You know, he's probably going to land us on the left side. Probably going to take us exit by one of the Juliets. Take Juliet to Bravo. God, please, please.
I know.
Juliet, Bravo, Kilo.
Hawker 850, Kilo Echo, turn right on Bravo, hold short of Juliet, and contact ground point niner.
Right on Bravo, hold short of Juliet, point niner, 0 Kilo Echo.
Yeah, I know, I'm the same way at work. Like, you know, when I'm flying.
Yeah.
I have to go back and forth.
It's kind of ridiculous.
Yeah.
All right, one notch of flaps in. Check everything, we're looking good. That, yep, we're good.
Nice.
Landing at Tulsa International Airport.
Oh yeah.
It was busy there for a minute, but there's not really anybody in the pattern.
Yeah, there was kind of a lull here in a minute. I guess we came in just the perfect time.
Good to go.
Flaps
two. Gotta trim it just a little. Maybe a touch too much.
Yeah, all right. So much glad you can't even see the Pappy over there.
On. Right on. Oh Lord, won't you buy me Mercedes Benz? Bow, bow, bow. My friends all drive Porsches.
must make amends.
Is it ready to write down the,
No, we're good.
Taxiways. 30.
Yep.
All right, we're a little high.
Hey, if a jetliner can land, we can.
Absolutely. All right, now we're good. See, two red, two white.
Yep.
Tower, Dozer 341, visual for 18 left.
Dozer 341, Tulsa Tower. Wind 18020, and I want it left clear to land.
Got a gust today, ain't it?
Left, Dozer 341.
Don't forget about me on final.
Yeah,
clearing other people to land.
Please don't run over us, it hurt last time.
Oh, look at this poor airliner over here going, would you hurry up? Hey guys, it's just me. It's just me, guys. I'm trying to bring it in fast.
I know. Do what you gotta do, man. We'll go sterile for final.
Huh?
We'll go sterile for final?
Yes. Sterile for final.
Clear.
You know what? Screw that. Feels like we're going about 10 miles an hour.
Indeed.
Hey, Hunter November Bravo, Tulsa Tower, hold short running 18 left.
Nice. They give us a exit.
Not yet.
It's warm now.
November 02, Whiskey, turn right on Bravo, contact ground point niner.
Right on Bravo, ground point niner, see ya.
There we go. Put us way down here, didn't they?
Huh?
They put us way down here, didn't they?
No kidding.
Goodness me. Yeah, it's not a good idea to hit the lights, you know?
Good afternoon, Tulsa Ground, Cherokee 302 Whiskey off of 18 left on Bravo.
Tell where we're going, Pulse Air.
Yeah. Good afternoon, Tulsa Ground. Cherokee 302 Whiskey's with you off of 18 left on Bravo.
Cherokee 02 Whiskey, Tulsa Ground, where do you park?
Going to Tulsa Air.
We're 0 Juliet Whiskey Taxi Bravo Kilo crossing runway 18 right. It'll be at your own risk, not visible from the tower. And just report when you're on the ramp.
Bravo Kilo cross 18 right. Report when on the ramp. 02 Whiskey.
Ground number 3677 ready. Taxi back to gate 4.
Lindbergh 3677 Roger and
pull up to and hold short of runway 18 left.
Pull up to and hold short of 18 left at that kilometer 3677.
Brake check. Trying to get that stretch knocked down a little bit.
Just a little.
Yeah, it's kind of hard to see.
Oh well. There we go. Is what it is.
It's all right. Thanks for letting me flat out or flap with you, should
I
say.
Oh no, I'm glad I had you, man, with the all the taxi instructions.
Oh yeah.
Lindbergh 3677, I'm sorry, sir. And you're on the ramp right now, is that correct?
We're on Alpha, we're on Echo short of 18 left, but we can't take a left turn if you want us to.
There's a nice bird right there.
You're on taxiway Echo
short
of 18,
that's
okay. Lindbergh 3677, roger, hold short runway 18 left.
Okay, we'll hold short of 18 left. We can make a left and join Echo back north southbound if you want us to do that.
So, who's that?
Lindbergh 3677, I'm sorry, I just couldn't see you there, sir. Yeah, I have you now. South on Echo and hold short of runway, or actually, south on Echo, cross runway 26, and hold short of runway 18 left on Charlie.
All right, proceed south on Echo, crossing 26, holding short of 18 left on Charlie, Lindbergh 3677.
You were blending in up there, my eyes were playing tricks on me, sorry about that.
No problem, sir, thanks for the help.
Ground dozer 341's on Bravo, hold short, Juliet, parking at Tulsa Air.
Dozer 341, Tulsa ground, give way to traffic ahead left. Taxi via Bravo, Kilo, crossing runway 18 right, will be at your own risk, not visible from the tower. Report on the ramp.
Okay, Bravo, Kilo, and cross 18 right at our own risk, we'll report on the ramp, Dozer 341.
What are we doing car wise?
I think
we
only have trouble.
Or what?
The
I think Ryan's got a call here.
He's got a clearance.
Well, nice.
Yes, sir. Calling for clearance, or calling for the ATIS. When you get your clearance, I'll give you the ATIS as well.
Okay. Well, I'm ready to copy the clearance.
Clearance delivery on 134.05.
All right. Looks clear. Clear your right. Triple check. Clear right.
Delta Hotel Mike, you're at BizJet, ready to taxi?
Yes, with squawk code 5744.
X-ray Alpha Delta Hotel Mike, roger. Runway 18 left, taxi via Kilo, Bravo, Juliet.
18 left, Kilo, Bravo, and Juliet, Delta Hotel Mike.
All right. Pulse ground, check 8302, Whiskey's on the ramp. Turkey 8302 Whiskey, we are on the ramp, sir.
Thank you.
Go ahead.
Yeah, crack that, some bitch.
Easy now.
Oops!
There goes the YouTube channel.
Ah, that's okay.
X-ray Alpha Delta Hotel Mike, you're at BizJet right here by the tower, correct?
Yeah, he knows. He knows already.
We are no down.
He knows
down
already.
Next to BJet.
He knows I was. He knows I was cussing him the whole time.
Exactly. Yeah, he knows. All right.
You're gonna use.
VFR arrival procedures in effect. Runway 27 and runway 36 left and right in use. Stages 8 or 12 in the note handbook. Monitor Oshkosh approach control frequency 120.7 for runway assignment and frequency. Oshkosh Tower Controllers will assign either runway 36 left or runway 36 right. All VFR arrivals should turn transponders to standby within 30 miles of Oshkosh. Oshkosh arrival information, Kilo 2153 Zulu, wind 2708, visibility 10, view clouds 4500, 28.21, altimeter 29.74, RNAV and VOR runway 27 approach in use, VFR arrival procedures in effect, runway 27 and runway 36 left and right in use, stages 8 or 12 in the NOTAM book. Monitor Oshkosh approach control frequency 120.7 for runway assignment and frequency. Oshkosh tower controllers will assign either runway 36 left or runway 36 right. All VFR arrivals should turn transponders to standby within 30 miles of Oshkosh.
Alright. I'm good. Shoulder blade, man. Know what I did.
Trying to fit?
Uh-huh. Yeah, I saw. He called me old. Right. His butt'll be old one day. But at least you won't be old and lonely. From Ripon, 23 minutes to destination. Starts descending just a touch.
Approaching Gish with the left landing light on. If you have your rocky wings, and tell me where you're from.
Crystal Lake, Illinois.
Crystal Lake, that's beautiful over there. That's fantastic. Thanks for coming in today. We appreciate having you. Nobody in or around your vicinity, so I'll tell you what. How about you take a pick? Runway 27 or runway 36. Before you decide, the winds are 260.10.15.
That's 27.
27 it is. Here we go. Keep following the train tracks to the northeast. Look for a gravel pit. Make the right turn inside that gravel pit for a tight right downwind on runway 27. So far, so good?
Roger.
Then, once you're on the downwind, they're going to call your base just before that good big body of water out to the east. So keep it tight and plan for it. You can change tire frequency down 118.5. Thanks for coming. Have a great day.
Thank you, sir. Have a good week.
Just a sprain or a pull. Probably just stretched it funny.
But we're landing out of the net back.
You know what? It's probably from landing as well as I have been. I've been really putting a lot of muscle into landing. See, that'll be a good deal. I'll make some captain happy someday, because I'll do their landings, they can take off. I'm not good at anything else.
Alright, is that traffic over here?
Yeah. I'm looking for it. How high?
Okay, below us?
Yeah, I got it in sight.
Okay.
Hey, Jackwagon, get behind me.
Okay, sterile cockpit from here in.
Awesome.
This approach, this coop is behind. Air coop is behind the highway. Did you get me?
Okie doke, I understand I got an air coop inbound behind another aircraft. That's good, good. I see you guys out there. I got 1, 2, and 3, and 4. Got a nice string going out. There's number 5. I see the lights. As you're coming inbound from Ripon, just follow those train tracks for me to the northeast. Directly overhead the train tracks, please. Don't go point to point on me. And pick somebody up. Nose to tail, no side by side, no over under. This is not a racetrack. And as you get close to Fisk, we're going to pick you out. Now, so let you guys know, the winds are 260, 10, gust 15. So I'm guessing we're probably going to go to runway 27 if that's your liking. Otherwise, runway 36 is available. You just have to let me know as we get here. And I'll pick you out and I'll ask you a couple questions as we do so. Now, Oshkosh, just a few more minutes away. So as you guys are getting here, don't get too antsy on me. I have a high wing just approaching Fisk right now. Rock your wings and tell me where you're from. Which runway would you like?
Runway 27, please.
Okie doke, I got the high wing with a rocket. Where are you from?
From Modesto, California, 96 kilo.
And that was the high wing, is that correct, from Modesto?
High wing, Modesto.
Okay, there's two out there. Hang on 1 second for me now. I got a low wing that's following a high wing. You're going to be number two. Now, the high wing, you're going to go runway 27 as you requested. Low wing, I see that route. Thank you much. There's a number three out there just approaching Fisk. No landing lights on, but you're looking good. You're number three. Would you rock your wings for me, please? Okay, good. That's a good rock. That's number three. Very good. Number four out there with the twin clips. You got your lights lit up out there. You're number four. You're about a mile and a half southwest of Fisk. Go ahead and rock your wings for me. Ah, oh, you guys are doing fantastically. Well done. Okay, we've got everybody lined up in a row. Spacing looks fantastic, boys and girls. This is very, very good. Yellow high wing, I need you to pedal as fast as you can because everybody else behind you is following you and you are the leader. So continue the train tracks northeastbound for runway 27. Y'all are going to go to runway 27 unless somebody else speaks up and they say they want to go to 36. I'll give you that chance in just a second. The estimate is 2975. Look for the gravel pit. Keep the turn to the downwind inside that gravel pit and be ready for a close in right base. You can change the tower frequency now for the yellow. 118.5. The low wing following the yellow, you can go ahead and change also to 18.5. Number three, you rocked your wings for me. You did a nice job, 18.5. Number four, you're coming up with Fisk right now. Is 27 okay for you? I got a just over Fisk now. If you hear me, rock your wings. Good job. Okay,
now we're 18 miles.
27, thank you.
Alrighty guys, you're 5 in trail, spacing looks good. The teal tip Cherokee just passed off my left shoulder, I'm off your left side, thank you much, tower's 18.5. Let's see, I got a blue Cherokee, I'm sorry, a white Cherokee with a dark tip nose and a dark tip wings. Tower's 18.5, thanks guys, appreciate it. Then the high wing, just passed on the Fisk, same for you, 18.5. You guys have a great day, thanks again for coming to Oshkosh.
Working on it.
The reason saying so we're not just sitting on top of somebody.
Low wing just over Fisk now. Rocky wings, let me just let me know you're here. Tell me where you're from. Got a low wing just passing Fisk. If you hear me, Rocky wings.
A little bit slower.
That ends at just north of Fisk, in contact tower, 118.5, good day. Low wing coming up on Fisk, rock your wings and tell me where you're from. Got a low wing just coming up on Fisk, looks a little bit higher than 1800 feet, if you hear me, rock your wings.
Not to call anyone out.
One more time for the low wing coming up over the top of Fisk right now.
Rocky
wings. All right, there's a rock. That's good. Where are you coming in from?
Runway 36.
I missed that. I'm sorry, one more time. All right, the low wing that just rocked for me, you're doing a nice job. Keep following the train tracks to the northeast, except for my 27 for a tight right downwind. There's about 5 aircraft ahead of you. Spacing looks good. Now change frequency 118.5 from my 27. Have a great day. There's a high wing coming inbound from Ripon. Looks like you might be going point to point via the RNAV. If you would, please make sure you follow the train tracks. Don't skip out of the train tracks on me, please. No point to point. Train tracks are off your right side. Keep following those inbound to Oshkosh. There is no point to point from Ripon to Fisk. Follow the train tracks, please. High wing north of Ripon, doing almost northbound. If you hear me, rock your wings.
Ninety-two knots ground speed.
Yeah, I like it.
That's from, we'll keep it at.
High wing approaching Fisk, just slightly west of Fisk. High wing, north northeast one. If you hear me, rock your wings, please.
You lit up?
Ah.
You lit up?
Yes.
Okay, all aircraft inbound from Ripon to, okay, you're looking good, there we go. All aircraft inbound from Ripon to Fisk for the Oshkosh arrival. Follow the train tracks, don't forget, follow the train tracks. No point-to-point RNAV today, please. Follow the train tracks out of Ripon, 1,890 knots. Gonna head directly to Fisk through the train tracks, and then expect them at 2-7 today. The winds are 26010, gust 15, the altimeter 2975. The Cessna over Fisk now, if you hear me, rock your wings.
There's a terrain alert.
Got another high wing just doing the wing rock.
Just to our right.
Spokane, Washington.
Spokane, Washington. Okay.
Wow.
There's a high wing at your 11 o'clock and about 2 miles. If you see him, let me know.
I thought he looked like he was pointing to the north.
Here to our right.
Yeah, it looks like he changed his mind. Apparently he wants to come and play too. So he's taking the 12 o'clock position on now, about 2 miles ahead. Spacing looks good. 2-7 okay for you today? The wind's 260 at 10 gust 15.
Yeah, we'll take 2-7. I have that traffic in sight.
Look, plan to follow him, but he's not talking to me, so just keep an eye on him if you would, please. Expect runway 2-7 today. Base, I'm sorry, downwind turn inside the gravel pit and base inside the beach. As you pass overhead, Fisk can change frequency 118.5, 18.5 from Tower. Hey, thanks again for coming. Appreciate having you here.
Thanks for your help.
Everybody's coming in to get in the pattern, aren't they?
The high wing over Fisk, if you hear me, rock your wings and tow away from. Looks like there's a high wing coming over the top of Fisk right now. If you hear me, rock your wings. There you go, there's a little gentle wing, wing rock. Where are you coming from?
Right, Pacer from Auburn, Nebraska.
Auburn, Nebraska. Gotta love you guys from the Central States. Thank you very much for joining us. Normally 2-7 today, keep following the train tracks to the northeast. And look for a gravel pit. You're going to make the right turn to the downwind, the right downwind runway 2-7 inside that gravel pit. And expect your base inside the shoreline for a long landing to runway 2-7. Just heads up, the winds are 26010, gust 15, and the altimeter is a steady 2900.75. Change the tower frequency now, 118.5, 18.5. Thanks for coming, guys. Have a great day.
Thank you, sir. Have a great day.
may get there first.
Can you see the tower?
I see it. It's to the left. My 11 o'clock. Got it, on my wingtip.
So this is, guys, this is who we're gonna watch right here.
Yeah.
Power behind you.
That sounds good. Oh, that'll be no problem. That'll be no problem. He's gonna get there way before we do.
How much do we need, Trail?
Do
we need half a mile, Trail?
Half a mile.
Looks like a 182.
Aircraft inbound to Oshkosh via the Fisk Arrival. Thanks for coming, appreciate having you. Good to see you. When you depart Ripon, make sure you follow the train tracks to the northeast. Directly overhead the train tracks now, please. No lefty-righty, no upside-downies. Just follow the train tracks all the way up to Fisk for me, please. When you hit Fisk, we're going to pull you off runway 36 or runway 27. The choice is going to be yours, just because we love you. The winds at Oshkosh reported 260-10 gust 15, and the altimeter 2975.
All right, we got an airplane.
Okay, then we'll change the winds now at 270 at 6. So, a little more amicable for either direction is going to be your choice. Got a high wing coming up over Fisk. If you hear me rock your wings, and I tell you what, let me know where you're coming in from.
Oklahoma City.
Oklahoma City, is that what you said?
Yes, sir.
Oklahoma City, home of the Mike Maroney Aeronautical Center, Center of Air Traffic Controllers. We appreciate you, love you, thank you for coming out to Oshkosh. How are you doing today?
I'm doing great.
Now our goal is just to keep separation with him.
27 okay for you today?
27 will be just fine.
Thank you. Okay, well, you're on the right course. Just a few more minutes, we'll have you on the ground, let you pump up that flat spot on your body. And keep following the train tracks to the northeast. Look for a gravel pit, make a right turn inside that gravel pit for a tight right downwind to runway 27. You're going to see a good big body of water out to the east. They're going to base you before that body of water in case you don't know how to swim. Runway 27 is the active. Again, the winds are 2706. The altimeter is a steady 29.75. Change the tower frequency now, 118.5. You guys have a great day, and thanks for coming down.
He's at 2300 feet.
Thanks for your help.
There's a Cherokee right behind us too. That Cherokee, we ended up splitting the middle between these and the other one.
Worked out perfect.
Oh, it did. Yeah, it did work out great. All right, back to concentrating on speed. Off my screen.
Got a low wing coming up over Fisk. If you hear me, rock your wings. Very nice. Okay, where are you coming inbound from today?
I see you. We're coming in from Wichita, Kansas.
Wichita, Kansas. That's no short flight. It's good to have you here. How are you guys doing?
Say again.
Looks like you guys are doing pretty well today. How about runway 27? The winds are 2706.
27 is fine.
Okay, so runway 27 it is. Continue following the train tracks to the northeast, and you're going to see a gravel pit. You want you to make a right turn inside of that gravel pit, tight right downwind to runway 27. Select the base turn prior to the shoreline, and everybody's landing along runway 27 today. The altimeter at Oshkosh is 29.75. I'd like you to change frequencies now to the tower, 118.5, 18.5. Guys, thanks for coming. Appreciate having you. Have a great day.
Roger, we're going at 118.5.
further and dash behind.
Lord, we apologize for mocking the old man's voice on the radio. Amen. A little faster than 90 knots, which is fine.
I got a twin coming up over Fisk. If you would, do me a favor, slow it down just a little bit. The winds are 2706. How does runway 36 sound to you?
I'd rather have 27.
27 it is, that's not a problem, but you're going to follow a guy who's quite a bit slower than you, so if you would, do me a favor, pull the throttles back a little bit, let those little wheels dangle down some, and maybe throw out a set of flaps for me. You're going to follow a blue slow mover. He's right now about a mile and a half ahead, but you're going to eat him up if you don't slow it down for me. Keep following the train tracks to the northeast, look for a gravel pit. At the gravel pit, make a right turn to a tight right downwind to runway 27. Winds are 2706 and the altimeter is 2975. Everything good?
Some people.
Over top of Fisk, if you would now, monitor tower 118.5. The spacing looks good and the speed looks fantastic. Thanks, guys. I appreciate it. Have a great day.
My goodness, I'm fine.
High wing, coming up over the top of Fisk. If you hear me, rock your wings, please.
There we go.
Very nice. Where are you guys coming in from today?
A beautiful ball ground, Georgia.
Georgia? Okay, then. Great to have the Southern Fork up here. Thank you very much for joining us. How does runway 27 sound to you today? The wind is 2706.
That just sounds just wonderful.
Okay then, so be it. It'll be runway 27. Keep following those train tracks to the northeast for me if you would, please. And look for a gravel pit. At the gravel pit, make a hard right turn for a tight right downwind to runway 27. The base will be before the shoreline, and you can contact the tower now. 118.5, actually just monitor them. 118.5. Thanks for coming, guys. Low wing over Fisk. I got a pair of them, actually. If you hear me, both of you. Rocky wings. All right, nice, in unison even. Wow, synchronized wing rockers. That's great, guys. Okay, you're going to follow the high wing ahead, and runway 27 it is. The winds are 2706, altimeter 2975. Guys, thanks for coming. Appreciate having you here. Have a great day. 18-5.
Sir, we just wanted to shout out from Fort Worth, Texas, and Tulsa, Oklahoma. My buddy proposed to his girlfriend yesterday, so congratulations are in order.
Hey, all right, we'll take the shout out all day long. We'll pass the word along. Congratulations, guys. Love having you here. Thanks for coming to Oshkosh. You guys enjoy the week.
Thanks for your time, sir.
Congrats, Matt.
Yeah, 464 Bravo Charlie, what dock do we land on?
That controller, he said congrats, Matt.
Number 4,
oh,
Bravo Charlie.
Oh, nice.
Down, and you can expect to land on the orange dot for runway 27.
Nice, bud.
For you shortly.
464.
Dude, that's awesome, brother. We're here.
So we're inside the gravel pit. Follow that Cessna. 27, go to land.
We're here. Almost tear jerking. Almost.
4-5-5, we'll be going over to the EA weak hanger.
4-4 Bravo Charlie, turn back out a little bit. I don't have the base turn for you quite yet. If you just turn back out on the downwind, you're following a citation on a short final.
We're looking for him. I see him.
I see him.
In November, 4 Bravo Charlie, can start your base turn now, runway 27, orange dot, clear to land, caution light turbulence for a landing citation.
Orange dot, that's the first one, right? Yeah, that's the first one.
Number 4 Bravo Charlie, copy, start the base turn now.
4-6 Bravo Charlie, turn at base.
Oh, no, that's so funny.
The bear and a beam the tower on the downwind, start your descent. November 464 Bravo Charlie, runway 27 orange dot, bring it all the way to the orange dot. You are clear to land. The wind 280 at 7.
64 Bravo Charlie.
Oh my gosh, dude, they're not anywhere near. Oh, they're not far from the shower houses at all. they're not far from the shower houses at all. That's good.
So you see the gravel pit?
Yeah, I got this, brother. You just do your thing. I'm good. I'm your own. I promise you.
Okay. Bravo 2 to Flagman Parking,
4-5-5-6. 4-5-5-6. You can make the right turn, and then you can contact Ground Point 9, or he'll help you get to parking.
He needs to make his base, though.
Bear entering your base turn now. Let me see.
So the Cessna needs to make his downwind. We're in Oshkosh, baby boy. Alright, so for
Cessna
sure...
Cessna High over the gravel pit on the downwind, start your descent, please.
So for sure... Let me put that sign up, because we'll be close.
Everybody inbound for 27 over the railroad tracks. Keep your downwind inside the gravel pit. Expect a left turn off the runway with no delay for traffic following behind. Thank you. Welcome to Oshkosh.
The orange dot?
Yeah, that's the first one.
Yeah.
Number 464 Bravo Charlie, turn left when you're able. As soon as you're able, please, for traffic behind and follow the flagman to parking. Welcome.
4 Bravo Charlie.
Low wing, a beam the tower, start your descent on the downwind.
Yep.
Just now, beam the number, start your base turn now, runway 27 orange dot, clear to land. Lowing, just passing by the tower now. Also turn your base to be in the numbers, runway 27 orange dot, clear to land.
I guess I'm following him, but he went further than a beam the numbers. He went way further than a beam the numbers.
Slow it down.
Oh yeah.
Bearing on the rollout, turn left as soon as you're able. Follow the flagman to parking, enjoy your stay. And if you do need the hard surface, there is the left turn. Lowing and being the numbers, start your base turn now, runway 27, orange dot, clear to land.
Gosh, in the sun.
Just yep. On the road, a left turn into the grass as soon as you're able, please, for traffic behind and follow the flagman. Welcome. Going on the road, left into the grass as soon as you're able, please, and follow the flagman to parking.
Get our signs ready.
Now left turn on the rollout, please.
Left turn here?
Yep, right here. That's right here.
Going on the road, left turn when you're able, follow the flagman to parking. Welcome.
Oh yeah. Alright, once we turn in to the actual parking lot, or to the actual campsite, we'll pull that sign out.
This one, the one I got out?
Yeah. Bouncy.
There you go. I'm proud of you.
Oh, I do. Yeah, that's habit, man. Boy, God dang. We have a sign on our airplane that says something cool because everyone's giving us thumbs up.
Because I do it.
Oh, did you? Okay. You dork. That the guy that was on the radio? Okay, now, now 512 by the shower. Dude, can I make this without, okay, there we go, that's pretty good. Yeah, throw it out there and see what they say. I'm not far. I'm in 5'10".
indicate it, go to the green dot, and then put it down left in the grass. My guy, just inside the shoreline right now, you look beautiful. Space is fine, runway 27, clear to land. And I want everybody, I see my guy and my high guy turning this base at the lake. You're doing great. Ready to turn to final, runway 27, clear to land, start your descent. Do I have anybody else on the down one right now? Go around Cessna, Cessna, go around, enter the right crosswind. Cessna, go around and enter the right crosswind.
How about the missed approach?
Cessna, turn right crosswind now. Guy inside the shoreline, just inside the lake, you're doing beautiful. Spacing's good, runway 27, clear to land. My guy in the middle of the lake, turn final. Right now, you're turning inside traffic on a second 4 mile final. My Cessna on the runway, get off the runway for me now. Turn left off the runway. Third one, Zoom, the guy just on the runway rolling out, just past the orange dot, short of the green dot, turn left into the grass. Everyone's doing great. One Zulu Zulu, turn to the railroad tracks. My dark wing aircraft is just approaching the shoreline. Can you continue and turn your base right now? My guy at the shoreline who's on the downwind, turn base. I have two guys on top of each other at the lake. The guy who executed the mist, you're doing great. Thank you for your help. You're going to go to the departure end of the runway and turn right, re-enter the right downwind. High wing, it's my dark guy that's turning base to the shoreline. You're doing beautiful. Really turn bottom.
Mm-hmm.